This Wi-Fi booster pack, it's a Texas Instruments CC3100, normally doesn't allow you to program it directly. There is an ARM chip on board that can be programmed and there is flash memory, but there is no access to it by default. You need to purchase a dedicated other device to be able to talk to it and to program it. But I have a trick to use another launchpad, in this case an MSP 432, but you can use virtually any launchpad, to talk to that chip and to flash the memory. The serial communication send and receive are available on this adapter here. These two last settings, they are the receiving and the transmitting line. So you have to remove those two jumpers and then link those jumpers to the right connections on the booster pack. You also have to tap off the 3.3 and the ground signal from the booster pack. If we want to talk to the flash of the CC3100, we have to access the controller via its serial communication port. And the sender and receiver channel are here, pin 3 and pin 4 of connector 1. As long as we can manage to set up a communication from our PC to this booster pack over serial, then we should have access to that flash. And all of the launchpads have that kind of access. They all have a USB bus that you can connect to the laptop, and that then turns into a serial communication port. So what we now have to do is look at the launchpad and see how we can get at those pins from the debugger. I'm using an early version of the MSP432 launchpad, and you can find the debugger here on the right side of the PCB. The left side is the microcontroller side, and there is a bridge between the debugger and the microcontroller, and we'll hack into that bridge. You'll see that there are two signals that we need that are just available here, and that is the USB serial receive and transmit line. So we can remove those two jumpers. That way we disconnect the debugger line from the microcontroller. We won't use the microcontroller in this exercise. And then we can tap these signals with a patch cable. The receiving line from the USB of the debugger should go to the sending line of the booster pack, and the sending line, the transmit line of the debugger, should go to the receive line of the booster pack. We also need power on the booster pack, so we can use the ground and the 3V3 from this pin here. We'll also have to plug in the USB cable of the booster pack, because this launchpad can't deliver enough power to fuel the booster pack by itself. So in summary, we remove those two jumpers. The receiving line here will go to the transmit line of the booster pack. The transmit line here goes to the receive line of the booster pack. Ground to ground, 3V3 to 3V3. Okay, I've done that. The power I've connected through the lower right connector here on the launchpad, the ground and the 3V3. And then for the serial signals, I have put a gray cable on the receiving line and a purple cable on the transmitting line of my serial connection. And then when you connect them to the booster pack, you have to switch them, because the sender becomes the receiver on the other side and the other way around. And that ends up in using the purple cable in connector 1 pin 3 and the gray cable in connector 1 pin 4. There is also on that same connector room for the 3V3 and the ground cable. When you connect this to your laptop, take care that you connect both USB cables, because the launchpad doesn't have enough juice to fuel the booster pack. We've made the connection and we can now power the booster pack and the launchpad. First, connect the booster pack via USB to your laptop. This only serves as a power line. There is no data going between laptop and booster pack. All data goes via the patch wires that we've just used. And then plug in your launchpad. But you need to know which COM port is assigned to that launchpad. So use the tool on your operating system that can check that. Plug in the launchpad, and then you'll see that a new COM port will arrive. And for me, the UART of my launchpad is COM port 8. I have to remember this because our flash tool will use this setting. And now we can fire up UniFlash. And you'll see that this is not the very latest version of UniFlash, because that one doesn't support the CC3.1 family yet. So check on the TI download site for the supported hardware and check that you have the right one for CC3100. It's clearly documented. We can then do a new target configuration, and we select the CC3X serial UART interface.
And there is only one board or device available here, so we can't select anything else. So let's do OK. Then we enter the COM port that we saw that was assigned to the launch pad. That's COM port A. And we can try things out. Don't ever format here unless you exactly know what you're doing, because you may delete essential files on your CC3100. You don't want to do that. But let's list the file system. And there is something specific when we connect to the booster pack. Once the connection is being set up, you have to press the reset button of that booster pack. It is the switch 2. So you'll see here that if I click list file system, we will see a red line because the connection fails. And that's a good moment to press and release that reset button, because then the next connection will work and you get a full listing of all the files on your booster pack. So we have now successfully made a connection to the booster pack, checked the flash, checked what files, what data is available there. And the fact that we can read the flash and that we can access it means that you can also now do your own things with that CC3100 without requiring special hardware. You can just use your launchpad, talk to the flash. You could upload a new service pack. You could load programs to there. Let me know what useful or unuseful things you were able to do with this.